Welcome to the Blazor Smart TextArea component tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to get started with the Syncfusion Blazor Smart TextArea component. This AI-powered component auto-completes sentences in real time, predicting your next words. It makes filling out forms or writing documents easier, enhancing efficiency and reducing typing effort. Before proceeding, ensure that you have the .NET 8 SDK and Visual Studio 2022 installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the Blazor web application, then provide the project name. I am using .NET 8 as the framework for this project. Notice that I have selected the interactive server mode because this component is fully compatible with server interactivity mode apps. Apart from this, there are four other modes. To learn more about interactive render modes, check out the video linked in the YouTube card above. I'll continue the project creation with the global interactivity location. When I click the Create button, the project creation will start. Now the application is ready to use. Next, let me proceed to add the Blazor Smart TextArea component. First, I'll install the required NuGet package in my application. So, open the NuGet package manager, switch to the Browse tab, search for the Syncfusion Blazor Smart Components package, and install the latest version. I also install the Themes NuGet package to include the CSS and script files. After installation, navigate to the Imports Razor file and add the Syncfusion Blazor Smart Components namespace. This is used to implement the component in the Pages folder. Next, I open the program CS file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then, I register the Syncfusion Blazor service to use the Smart TextArea component. Next, I need to connect the application to an AI service using the provided credentials, allowing the component to analyze data intelligently based on AI predictions. First, I declare the string variable named API key. This is a secret key provided by the AI service to authorize requests. Next, I declare a string variable named deployment name, which refers to the name of the deployment where the AI model is running. Finally, I declare the endpoint variable, which represents the base URL of the AI service used to send inference requests. These strings represent the essential credentials required to connect to the AI service provided by the Azure OpenAI service. If you want to know how to obtain the API key, deployment name, and endpoint, check the Microsoft documentation link provided in the description below. After that, I import the Syncfusion Blazor Smart Components namespace. This namespace used to register AI services. Then I register Syncfusion Smart Components with the Blazor Apps Dependency Injection System and configure the AI service credentials, including the API key, deployment name, and endpoint. This allows components like the Smart TextArea to access AI-powered features, enhancing user interactions with automatic data completion and suggestions. Next, I navigate to the AppRazor component, host the script, and refer to the CSS for the component. With everything is configured, open the HomeRazor component, remove the default code, and define the Syncfusion Blazor Smart TextArea component. This component allows you to enter multi-line text, making it ideal for capturing long responses or queries. Then I add the placeholder property, which provides text that appears inside the text area when it's empty. Let's run the example application. You can see the Smart TextArea component is rendered with the placeholder. When I attempt to paste more than two lines, only part of the content may be visible. To increase the visible lines, I set the row count property to 5, defining the number of visible rows in the text area. For appearance customization, I set the width property to 80%. Additionally, add the float label type property is set to auto, so the label floats above the text area when it's focused or contains text. Look, now you'll see the Smart TextArea rendered with the specified width. When clicking on the text area, the label floats above the input field, allowing both the label and typed text to remain visible. Now, paste in content displays properly within the Smart Text area. Next, I'll demonstrate role-based auto-completion. To achieve this, add the code block. Here, I declare a string variable named userRole. This string defines the user's role when interacting with the Smart Text area. Then I add a userRole property and bind it to the userRole variable. This property indicates the user's role in interacting with the Smart Text area. As I type content based on the given role, you'll notice auto-suggestions appearing that are tailored to the userRole. Next, I'll show you how to add predefined user phrases in the Smart Text area component. To do this, I declare an array of string named user phrases, which contains common phrases for this user role. When the user types in the text area, these phrases will be suggested as auto-completions. Then I bind the user phrases property to this array, allowing the component to suggest phrases based on the user's role. Please note, the user phrases property is optional, and you can choose to use it if you want to provide predefined suggestions. Now, as I start typing one of the predefined phrases, you'll notice that the rest of the content is automatically suggested. This functionality makes it easier to fill out forms or write documents, significantly improving efficiency and saving typing effort. Next, I'll show you how to customize the appearance of the suggestions. To do this, I set the Show Suggestions on Pop-up property to true. This allows you to control how text suggestions are displayed to users. Now, as I type content based on the selected role, you can see the suggestions appearing in a pop-up window. Next, I will demonstrate how to fill the text content automatically based on the role chosen in the Syncfusion Blazor Dropdown List component. I've already added the Syncfusion Blazor Dropdown List component with Data Source property, bound to the Role Options list for selecting user roles. Also, I added on Role Change event to handle the drop-down value change. Additionally, I included the @bindValue property to dynamically update user phrases based on the selected role in the drop-down. To learn more about getting started with the Syncfusion Blazor Dropdown List component, check the video and documentation links provided in the description below. Let's run the example application. As you can see, the Smart Text Area component is rendered with the drop-down list. I'll choose Employee Communicating with the Internal Team from the drop-down list. When I type predefined phrases for this role, content suggestions appear automatically. Then I choose the third role, type predefined phrases, and the remaining content is suggested automatically, completing the process smoothly. This functionality makes it easier to fill out forms or write documents, significantly improving efficiency and saving typing effort. Now let me summarize. I've shown you how to get started with the Syncfusion Blazor Smart Text Area component. I also walked through the customize the appearance of the suggestions in this component. If you want to see the working code for this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link to check if you qualify for a free community license to access all our Blazor components. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. Thanks for watching.